We have options. You can sit, you can lay down, it's whatever you feel like doing. It
just
depends.
Have the interview. Like, okay,
yeah,
like
whatever. You want to lean? You can lean if you like.
I'll hover.
Yeah, I'm so happy to see you.
I just caught a glimpse of myself. I thought I'd buy this coat. It's like the New York Dolls, but actually it's more Sesame Street.
No, it's charming.
Come on, Jimmy, try my coat on. You can make it look cool.
You
if
think
anyone
so?
Can make it look cool. You can do it. Look at this. Wow.
Not bad. I think you rock it. I think you know it.
No, you got to do
it. You know what this is?
What?
This is Buster Keaton if he was a pimp.
It does look like that. That's so funny.
I do look like
Buster Keaton.
You do look like
Thank
Buster
you. I
Keaton.
Take that. I love that. That's a compliment. I love this.
I can't believe I took my coat off and revealed my Bake Off paunch.
have you ever done that?
Try four up here.
Have you ever done the bottle
flip? Oh yeah, yeah. It's easy. Watch.
No, it's a simple thing, right?
Is it? How does it work?
No, that's it.
That's it. Oh.
Angela Bassett makes it look easy.
When you've been doing it as long as me, you can do two at the same time.
It's so good. Yeah, I just love doing it. Anyway, we won't have to worry about this. The jacket, comes off.
Buster Keaton.
Yeah, come on, Buster
Keaton. Left-handed.
During the interview, just keep flipping it and see if it lands. I just want to say congrats, by the way, because you've become a dad since I think the last time I've seen you, now. A very cool dad. You have...
The weird thing about that is I don't have any children.
What does that mean? What does that mean?
You're just an abstract joke. Yeah. Someone said you're a dad now.
Yeah. But you do have two beautiful daughters.
I got two daughters. You've got two daughters.
Right? I do. Yeah.
I got a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old.
It's the best, right?
It blows my mind every day. Yeah. So I've got a little 5-year-old. I named after Salvador Dali, obviously, and she's like a little. She loves painting, and she's kind of ethereal and surreal. And then I've got a 3-year-old that I named Iggy, after Iggy Pop, and she wears a leather jacket, she smokes, she rides a motorbike.
She's
like a tank girl.
Tank girl.
The great thing about being a dad is you realise you know nothing. I was sitting with Dali, and she saw... She saw us in the mirror and she said, "Who's that?" And I said, "That's you." And she said, "No, but I'm here." And I went, "Yeah, but that's your reflection." And she went, "What's a reflection?" And I went, "I got nothing for you."
You really are Dali. That is really fantastic.
And then she basically went, "What's a shadow?" And I went, "Again, I've got nothing for you."
Isn't that great?
"Dada, why am I upside down when I look in a spoon? Again, I've got nothing."
Wow. She's fantastic.
Why are people upside down in spoons?
I have no idea. You're right.
Why are we upside down in spoons? Who made that decision? Okay, guys, I've got an idea. We're all going to be upside down in spoons. Anyone against that, raise their hand now.
Yeah,
what about ladles?
Now, you were part of the Great British Bake Off. I love this move because I knew you before that show.
Yeah.
And I don't...
Pre-Bake Off.
Yeah,
pre-Bake Off. Noli.
Yeah, that's what we used to call you. Back before we knew you were going to go on, we used to call you Pre-Bake Off Noli.
I know.
And then... But I thought that was one of the kind of most interesting choices to have you as one of the hosts.
And I mean, at that point, people didn't really know me as a person. I'd never done reality TV. I looked quite scary, a bit like Keith Richards in his prime. And I had a reputation as being quite a party guy. You know, I used to hang out with Courtney Love and Amy Winehouse. And then I think when I got that gig, Britain was horrified.
Yeah,
he was like, "Who's let Nosferatu in the tent?"
So this is like, but this is a a beautiful, this is a giant show. I mean, this is like the number one show in England.
I know.
Do you have any pressure to feel like you might ruin it or taint it?
It's like an institution, and everyone was mortified, and I just thought, I'm gonna have to leave England. I said, I can't do this. And then they brought in Paul Hollywood. I don't know if you've ever seen his eyes, they're very blue. And they wheeled him in, which is weird, because he can walk, and they wheeled him in.
It's in his contract. He must be wheeled
around.
He's
on a big throne. Yeah. It's got six wheels. And I looked into his beautiful blue eyes, and I sort of got sucked in for a moment and dived into his blue eyes. And then I found myself in a waterfall naked. And when I came out, I'd done 8 seasons, so there you go. And
that's a beautiful story. It's a beautiful story.
And
you're a crowd favorite.
As a cheeky bonus, I've got 2 children now. I don't know how that happened.
From the waterfall. From the waterfall, yeah. People love you. The audience loves you. I couldn't see the show without you now, and I just love getting to know you on there and seeing how, first of all, how friendly you are, but also you're very funny. You're brilliantly funny, but just to get to see that side of you, the friendly side and just the open side and how nice you are.
You know what? It's the best job in the world. Like, you wouldn't... I don't know why you would... You'd never leave that show. It's just like it's on a stately home. There are lambs frolicking. Prue Leaf is amazing.
Yeah,
Alison,
she's great.
Alison Hammond's just joined. It's so good.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
just
the picture
such a lovely, lovely show. And the bakers are so good. And they're so brilliant at what they do. And they're really funny because they're not... they're not celebs, so they're sort of not guarded, and that you have really good, interesting chats with them, you know, and you can just improvise. So I sort of see it as, in a weird way, how I sort of positioned it in my head was, it's a bit like you're able to improvise in a sort of tent, which is a bit like a circus. And so for me, I just pretend to be in Morecambe Indy in a tent in a circus.
Yeah.
That's how I get up in the morning. You got to tell yourself. It's crazy.
That's how you wake up, yeah.
Yeah.
But let's talk about your new series.
Yeah.
This is the completely made-up adventures of Dick Turpin. It's very, very funny, very entertaining. Tell everyone what it's about and who you play.
Dick Turpin's a real guy. I don't think Dick Turpin's very well known in America. I think he's like Robin Hood, but Robin Hood robbed from the rich and gave to the poor, and Dick Turpin just robbed from the rich. So he's not... not a nice guy. Yeah. Criminal. I think he was famous for riding a horse to York, which is quite unusual, and then he got hanged. So we sort of, it's quite gruesome. So we thought, all right, let's reimagine Dick, yeah? I don't know if you've ever reimagined Dick and... No! Stop it. It's not that kind of show. We had a lot of meetings about Dick, and that... Seriously, once you go into this Dick tunnel, you can't come out. It's a nightmare.
Oh, my gosh. Mm.
I've always known I'd make a good Dick, but... So my Dick, me, the character Dick...
It's different than...
I can't get
it's
out
It's different
this.
Than... Your dick is different than his dick. Like, the histories.
This is potentially the end of the interview.
Flip the bottle. I want to show a clip. Here's Noel Fielding in the completely made-up adventures of Dick Turpin. Take a look at this.
My first highway robbery. I haven't been this excited since I discovered my own cheekbones.
Here's your gun, Dick.
Thank you.
That's the thing you shoot people with.
Okay, wow, that's quite small, isn't it? It looks like your gun gave birth to my gun. So I'm holding up a stagecoach with this, am I?
Yeah, actually, are you sure you don't want us to take the lead on this, seeing as you have no experience or knowledge and a tiny little gun?
I'll be fine now. Trust me, I've got this. Okay, guys, this is it. History in the making.
Okay.
We strike on 3. 1. 2. We'll get the next one. They move quite fast, don't they?
This is brilliant, man! That's so funny! I love it! No Fielding, everyone. The completely made-up adventures of Dick Turpin airs Fridays on Apple TV+. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around. Hey, hey.